Wouldn't it be great if somebody built an automatic green bin? Just toss in scraps and it turns into soil. Playing with worms on this edition of Science Alive. And we're with René-Claude Goulet here at the Canada Agriculture and Food Museum. What's in this box?
In this box, we have some worms.
Beautiful worms. How many worms do you think are in there?
Oh, probably thousands, easily.
Okay, and what are the worms eating?
The worms are eating some rotten food. They're eating some vegetable and fruit peels, some stems, some seeds, all kinds of things from the table scraps.
Right, so the idea is you would take a box like this, put it somewhere in your home, fill it with worms.
That's right.
And where do you get the worms from?
Well, I got the worms off the internet, off of Kijiji.
Right.
But you can get them in your garden. Now, what you're looking for is actually some tiny, tiny worms like this. I don't know if you can see it here. It's on the edge. We're looking for red wriggler worms.
Right.
Not the big, big chunky worms like the fishing worms we're used to seeing.
And you can put this box anywhere in your home?
That's right. Usually you want to keep it in the dark. And the worms don't like the light, so they'll hide away. You want to put this in a cabinet or a cupboard under the sink and feed it every week about whenever there's no more food for them to eat. When they've eaten everything out,
right,
you add some more.
So you'll be able to go and just take the lid off the box and look in and realize all that food you put in there is gone.
Exactly, and turn into this rich compost here. You see this you can put in your garden.
Right.
It'll feed your plants. This is composty. This is the juices that leak out of the box, and you can water your plants with this. You have to dilute it because it's extremely rich in nutrients for plants.
Yeah.
And this will be like a natural fertilizer.
And we call this an automatic green box because?
Well, the worms here do all the work. You basically never have to empty it. You have to harvest the compost every once in a while, but this takes quite a while to do.
Yeah.
This box is about 2 years old and I've never emptied it yet. I love to dig my hand in and just see it, like how many worms there are in here. It's crazy. I see you have a little handful here. You probably have about 15, 20 worms in there easily. So I'm just going to add some things today.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, we're going to put some tea bags.
Right.
Some coffee grounds, get the worms nice and hyper.
Yeah.
They love this stuff.
They love coffee.
You love coffee, believe it or not. Some grape stems, kiwi skin, some rotten old tomatoes, banana peel.
But what are you not putting in here?
Well, as you can see in my tray, I am not going to put the citrus peels, like grapefruit and lime. Worms don't really like that. It changes the acidity of their environment, and it makes it unpleasant for them.
Right.
And things like bread and bakery products, you're going to grow the wrong kind of organisms. You're going to get a lot of little white worms, and it's going to start being stinky as well. And you want to avoid any meat products. So everything except meat, citrus, and bakery products is good to go. Now, every time you add some food in there, you also want to add some dry carbon material, stuff that doesn't rot. So in this case here, we've got some egg cartons.
Yeah.
And this is going to balance it out and make sure the worms have everything they need to live. So if you want to do this at home, all you need is two bins of the same size. You drill holes in one of the bins so that the liquid can drip out.
Yep.
Sometimes worms will come out too. You have to check every once in a while and rescue the worms that came through, add them back in. But that liquid that drips down there, that's exactly what I was holding up earlier.
Cool. René-Claude Goulet and her automatic green box. Thank you for telling us about it.
You're welcome.
This was Science Alive.